وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى in this episode بإذن الله الكريم I want to go through the tafsir of a part of a verse إن شاء الله تعالى a segment, a small part of it where Allah تبارك وتعالى he says والذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقونها في سبيل الله فبشرهم بعذاب أليم This ayah, the scholars disputed one another whether it is abrogated or not. There is a view of scholars who say that it is this ayah is mansukha, it's abrogated, and it is abrogated with the ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where he says, خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَهِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا And also, it's abrogated with the hadith of Khalid ibn Aslam, and he said, خَرَجْنَا مَعَ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ بْنُ عُمَرَ We went out with Abdullah ibn Umar, رضي الله تعالى عنهما, فَقَالَ أَعْرَابِيٌّ أَيْ بَدْوٍ مَنْ said, أَخْبِرْنِي عَنْ قَوْلِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى Tell me about the verse of Allah, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةَ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَهَا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِّرْهُمْ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ Tell me about this verse. And Abdullah ibn Umar, رضي الله تعالى عنهما, he said, مَنْ كَنَزَهَا Anyone who treasures the wealth and keeps it in storages, فَلَمْ يُؤَدِّي زَكَاتَهَا and doesn't give the zakat from it, فَوَيْلٌ لَهُ Destruction be for that person. إِنَّمَا كَانَ هَذَا قَبْلَ أَن تُنْزَلَ الزَّكَاتِ This was before the zakat was sent down. Okay? فَلَمَّا أُنْزِلَتْ جَعَلَهَا اللَّهُ طُهْرًا لِلْأَمْوَالِ But when Allah تبارك وتعالى sent it down, He made it a purification for the wealth. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He made it a purification for the wealth. الشيخ محمد رشيد رضا he explains this and he said المراد the intent here is أن هذا الحكم وهو وجوب إنفاق كل ما يملك المؤمن من النقدين كان في أول الإسلام وقبل فرض الزكاة وليس معناه أن الآية براءت هذه نزلت قبل إيجاب الزكاة لما عليه الجمهور من أن الزكاة فرضت في السنة الثانية من الهجرة وبراءة نزلت سنة تسع انتهى كلامه محمد رشيد رضا he says in his tafsir al-manar the 10th volume page 351 he says the intent is that this ruling okay which is to give the or the obligation of giving every single thing that you possess from your money that was at the beginning of al-islam يعني but وَكَانَ قَبْلَ فَرْضِ الزَّكَاةِ And this was before the zakat was made obligatory. And that does, the meaning here, it doesn't mean that the ayah of Bara'ah, this ayah of Surah Al-Bara'ah, it came down before the ayah of making the zakat wajib. Like the Jumhur, Ahlul Ilmi believe. And that the zakat was made obligatory on the second year of the Hijriyah, right? Okay? And Bara'ah came down when? It came in the ninth year of the Hijriyah. So that view is saying that it's abrogated is far-fetched. The strong view is that the ayah is muhkama wala naskha fiha. And this is the call of the Jumhur al-Mufassirun. Jumhur al-Mufassirin, the majority of the Mufassirin, call al-Jumhur al-Mufassirin, the overwhelming majority of the Mufassirin, they believe this. You could go to the Kitab Nawasiq al-Qur'an by Ibn al-Jawzi, he expands on it. Ibn al-Jawzi rather, he says, Rahimahullah, regarding this verse, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةِ Those people who, يعني, storage their gold and their silver, وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ And they don't give it out for the sake of Allah, تبارك وتعالى. He says, اِخْتَلَفَ الْمُفَسِّرُونَ فِي هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ عَلَى ثَلَاثَةِ أَقْوَالِ That the Mufassiruna, the scholars of tafsir, they differed amongst themselves in three views. And then he mentions the first two views. And then when he comes to the third, he says, أنها في المسلمين, that this verse is regarding the Muslims. قالها ابن عباس, ابن عباس said it. والسدي, سدي also said it. وفي المراد بالإنفاقها هنا قولان. And also the ayah mentions ولا ينفقونها. The word infaq that's used here, there are two views regarding it, he says. أحدهما, one of the views is إخراج الزكاة. It means the giving out of the zakat. وهذا مذهب الجمهور, and that's the view of the overwhelming majority of the scholars. والآية على هذا محكمة, and that is that the verse is محكم, meaning this verse is not abrogated. And the second view is أن المراد بالإنفاق, that the infaq that's used in this verse is actually referring to what إخراج ما فضل عن الحاجة. It is to give out more than the need. And some of the مفسرون mentioned that, he said وقد زعم بعض نقلة التفسير أنه كان يجب عليه إخراج ذلك في أول الإسلام ثم نسخ بالزكاة وفي هذا القول بعد, he says. That's a far-fetched argument. And Imam al-Baghawi, he says الآية نزلت في منع الزكاة. The ayah came down, والذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقون في سبيل الله فبشرهم بعذاب أليم, that the ayah came down في منع الزكاة, people who refuse to give the zakat. لا في جمع المال الحلال. And the ayah is not talking about someone who's storing his wealth, which is halal. You can save up your money and you can reach a large number of money if you want to. You can't use this ayah and say to the people who are saving their money, والذين يكنزون الذهب والفضة ولا ينفقونها في سبيل الله فبشرهم بعذاب أليم. It's talking about the people who don't pay zakat from their wealth. Okay, so he said الآية نزلت في منع الزكاة لا في جمع المال الحلال. It's not talking about a person who gathers his wealth in a halal manner. He's giving the zakat from it, but he's still saving. Allah has given him, mashallah, a lot of income. The ayah is not talking about that person. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the prophet, he said نعم المال الصالح للرجل الصالح. So Baghawi brings that statement that the prophet said نعم المال الصالح. What a blessed wealth if it's owned by a blessed person. And if someone righteous has wealth, and it's going to be blessed, the way that wealth is going to be spent, and what will be done to that wealth. Ibn Ashur, rahimahullah, Ibn Ashur, he mentions the munasabah, the reason why this ayah is mentioned in the surah. Ibn Ashur, he mentions why, وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةِ, why is it mentioned in this surah? What's the reason? And he mentions that Ghazwat al-Tabuk, the battle of Tabuk, was a battle where the Sahabas who participated, and the time of that battle, it was fi waqti usratin. It was a time of hardship. وكانت الحاجة إلى العدة والظهر كثيرة. And at the time, the Sahabas really needed something to ride on, riding beasts. As Allah mentioned on the ayah, وَلَا عَلَى الَّذِينَ إِذَا مَا أَتَوْكَ لِتَحْمِلَهُمْ قلت لا أجد ما أحملكم عليه تولوا وأعينهم تفيض من الدمع حزنا ألا يجدوا ما ينفقون. Allah تبارك وتعالى mentions that the Sahabas, some of the Sahabas came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, and they said, Ya Rasulullah, take us with you into the battlefield. We want to go with you. And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he responded to them. He said to them, قلت لا أجد ما أحملكم عليه. I haven't got anything to take you with. They said, we want to participate in the battle with you, O Messenger of Allah. And the Prophet said, I haven't got anything to give to you in order for you to come with me. And then the ayah mentions, تَوَلَّوْا أَعْيُنُهُمْ تَفِيضُ, they turned away and their eyes were watering. مِنَ الدَّمْعِ حَزَنًا أَلَّا يَجِدُوا مَا يُنْفِقُونَ, they were saddened and heartbroken that there was nothing that they could bring to the table in order to go to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Okay? So Ibn Ashur mentions that this ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةَ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِرٌ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ, the reason why it was mentioned in this verse is because of this issue. Okay? The Sahabas were at this time going through a lot of hardship. So it's worth reading from there, inshallah ta'ala. So what does it ask? Now that we've mentioned all of that, so what is this ayah, Rama, what does this part of the ayah mean? وَالَّذِينَ يَكْنِزُونَ الذَّهَبَ وَالْفِضَّةَ وَلَا يُنْفِقُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ فَبَشِرٌ بِعَذَابٍ أَلِيمٍ. It means those people who gather the gold and the fiddah, the gold and the silver. Yani, dinar and dirham was the money that time, gold and silver. Each one represents a gold and a silver. In other words, wealth, the person who gathers the wealth together, and what does he not do? He doesn't give the zakat that he should be given from it. And the zakat here that's referred to is the zakat al-fitri, or zakat al-mali, or the zakat which are wajib. Okay, he doesn't give it. He also doesn't provide for the people he should be providing for, his children, or his wives, and his kids. He's got the wealth. He doesn't want to do it. Allah Ta'ala told the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to say to those people, فَبَشِّرُهُمْ, give them the glad tidings of what? Ya Muhammad bi'adabin muji'in. That these people are going to get an adab which is going to hurt them. It's going to really hurt them. Okay? Those people, tell them what's going to happen to them. It's like the ayah which Allah said in Surah Al-Imran. Allah says, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ, Allah Ta'ala, He said, sorry, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ هُوَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ بَلْ هُوَ شَرٌّ لَهُمْ سَيُطَوَّقُونَ مَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Allah Ta'ala, He says, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ, they should not think, الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ, the ones who are stingy. What are they doing? They're stingy with what? بِمَا آتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ, that which Allah Ta'ala gave them. They're stingy with it. They don't want to give from it. مِنْ فَضْلِهِ, the virtues Allah has bestowed upon them, the wealth Allah has given them. Then Allah Ta'ala, He says, those people who should not think who Allah has given them, His blessing, He's given them wealth, He's given them money. مِنْ فَضْلِهُ هُوَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ, that this is all good for them. بَلْ هُوَ شَرٌّ لَهُمْ, rather. What it is for them is evil. All this money and everything they have, and they're keeping it and they're storing it and they're not giving it out. بَلْ هُوَ شَرٌّ لَهُمْ سَيُطَوَّقُونَ, it will be tied around their neck. يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the day of judgment. Why? بِمَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ, because of the stinginess. So يُطَوَّقُونَ, it will be placed on their necks. Day of judgment, it will be placed on their necks. For what reason? مَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ. So يُطَوَّقُونَ مَا بَخِلُوا بِهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Okay, brothers and sisters, that's the danger of having wealth and not giving out for the sake of Allah. Also Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala, or not giving out in the things which are obligatory, that's the problem, that the wealth can become to you. Or that's the danger that wealth can have. Also the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, He said in the Qur'an, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ كَلَّا لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُطَمَةِ. He's collecting all of this wealth, collecting it. And he believes, الَّذِي جَمَعَ مَالًا وَعَدَّدَهُ يَحْسَبُ أَنَّ مَالَهُ أَخْلَدَهُ. He thinks that the wealth is going to stay forever. كَلَّا لَيُنْبَذَنَّ فِي الْحُطَمَةِ. And if you're not giving out the wealth in the places Allah obligated on you, then remember what's going to happen to you. Rather, there's a hadith that Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated, and the wording I'm going to mention is the wording of Imam al-Muslim rahimahullahu ta'ala, min hadith Abi Dharrin radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala, that the Prophet, He said, humul akhsaruna wa rabbil Ka'bah, the Prophet, He said, wallahi, they are the losers, the Lord of the Ka'bah. Okay, faqultu ya Rasulullah, Abi Dharrin al-Ghifari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, He said, oh Messenger of Allah, fa-fidaka abi wa ummi, I free my mother and father for you. Man hum, who are these people you're referring to? هم الأكثرون أموالا, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, they're the ones who have a lot of wealth. هم الأكثرون أموالا, they have a lot of wealth. Okay, إلا من قال هكذا وهكذا, except يعني the losers here I'm talking about are a lot, they are a people who have a lot of wealth. Then the Prophet gave an exception here. He said, except the ones who take their wealth, and what do? They do this, وهكذا وهكذا, the Prophet did his hands like that عليه الصلاة والسلام. مِن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ وَمِن خَلْفِهِ وَعَنْ يَمِينُ وَعَنْ شِمَالِ, he's giving it right, left, everywhere, he's giving it around. The Prophet then said, وَقَلِيلٌ مَّا هُمْ, little are these people who do that. مَا مِن صَاحِبِ إِبِلٍ وَلَا بَقَرٍ وَلَا غَنَمٍ, there's not a person who has a goat and a sheep and a lamb and a ram, whatever, it doesn't matter. Those أعيان which you need to pay the zakat from, they have it. لَا يُؤَدِّي زَكَاتَهَا, and they choose not to pay the zakat from. إلا جاءت يوم القيامة أعظم ما كانت وأسمنه, that same animal that you didn't pay the zakat from will come يوم القيامة, fat, big size, it will come. تنطحه بقرونها, and it will headbutt you with its horns. وتطوخه بأظلافها كلما نفدت أخراها, and they will start to trample on you. And whenever the first patch finishes, they go, it starts again. عادت عليه أولاها, it's going to be a cycle like that for you. حَتَّى يُقْضَى بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, until Qiyamah comes. That's how it's going to be. And you're on the ground. They headbutt you and they start to walk on you like that. Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَنْ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا, anyone who Allah gives him wealth, فَلَمْ يُؤَدِّي زَكَاتَهَا, and he doesn't give the zakat for it. مُثِّلَ لَهُ مَالُهُ شُجَاعًا أَقْرَأَ لَهُ زَبِيبَتَانِ, your wealth will be it will resemble a bald-headed, poisonous creature. Okay? There's yani black things on his eyes. That the day of judgment. What it will do, it would يَأْخُذُ بِهِلْزَمَتَيْهِ يَعْنِي شِدْقَيْهِ. It will take your cheek and it will bite on it. It will eat it. And it will be placed around your neck. And it will say to you, أَنَا مَالُكَ. I am your wealth. أَنَا كَنْزُكَ. I am your treasures. And then the Prophet recited the ayah, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ يَبْخَلُونَ بِمَا أَتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Until the ending. Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, she mentions, كنت ألبس أوضاحا من ذهب فقلت يا رسول الله أكنز هو فقال ما بلغ أن تؤدى زكاته فزكي فليس بكنز. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, she came up to him and she said, يا رسول الله, your messenger of Allah, she used to wear a gold. She said, يا رسول الله أكنز هو, is this كنز, that the ayah, والذين يكنزون الذهب, is it the كنز? فقال, the Prophet said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, ما بلغ, whatever reaches, and to add the zakat, that anything that reaches for the zakat to be paid for it, فزكيه, then the zakat should be paid for it. Okay? And anything that's not, then that's not a treasure. So there is an amount that it has to reach. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
Ramadan with AMAU. Make this the best Ramadan you've ever had by joining our exclusive online community with regular private classes, digital resources, weekly accountability sessions, and daily Qur'an gatherings. This is one opportunity you definitely do not want to miss. So sign up now at amau.org/Ramadan, and we look forward to welcoming you on the other side.